anything about his wife. I never saw him until I got inside. But when I walked through the door, the Spirit of the Lord exploded on the inside and said, tell my son, I said, I have given him the city. I have given. God said it, brother. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. And you will not believe the miracles and the signs and wonders that shall take place at Liberty. You will be able to walk in, brother, and see angels positioned. You will see the glory of God and the cloud of God. It shall be stationed. And people will be able to see it from 79th and from Western. They'll be able to see the glory cloud residing on the top of this place. And those of you that are here, saith the Lord, you are not here by coincidence. For I say unto you, I have summoned you. I have sent out my word. And you have answered a subpoena from God. God says, I have subpoenaed you to this ministry. God says, I have summoned you to this ministry. I've brought you out of your graveyard churches. I've brought you out of your dead churches. And I've brought you to life. I've brought resurrection to you, saith the Lord. Those things that were dead, saith God, they are alive tonight. Your miracles are here. Your deliverance is here. Your healings are here. Your finances are here. Yes, saith the Lord, your way of escape is in this place. To bring this city out of slavery. To bring this city out of bondage. To bring this city out of sin. To bring this city out of dope. You shall bring liberty to Chicago. You shall bring liberty to the captive, saith God. I shall bless your cupboards. I shall bless your storehouses. I shall bless the abundance of your wombs. I shall bless your finances. I shall bless your businesses. I shall bless your children. I shall bless your bosses. Everything you touch, saith God, I shall bless. In every direction that you stretch your hand, I shall bless. In every direction that you place your feet, I shall bless. In every direction that you turn your eyes, I shall bless. For my hand is upon you, saith the Lord. Your God is your help. Can we praise God? Hallelujah. Can we praise God? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come out of there. God wants to come out. That ministry, I lose it, saith God. The greater anointing, the greater ministry, the greater vision, saith the Lord your God. And hallelujah. This city belongs to this church. Take the city.
To the first part of the 2020 convocation meet and greet featuring the Family Feud.
Yay!
All right, I am your host, John Wesley, and we have two excellent teams, the Warrior and the Ego. In just a few minutes, they will be competing for a cash prize of $125.
That'd be $25,000.
Each player on the team will answer one question at a time, and you're to do so without cheating or worrying with your teammates or sending secret chats in sign language and all that stuff, Tara Digby. Okay. For Team Warriors, we have Carol Harrell, who will be the team captain. And we have Tara Digby. We have Stephen Willis. And we have Mary. Okay. Are we ready to have some fun?
Yes!
Yes. Well, let's get ready to rumble! Woo!
Wrong TV show.
That's all right.
First question. Name something you associate with Chicago.
The Bulls.
You said what?
The Bulls.
Okay, the Bulls.
All right.
Okay. So, Sister Nadine, would you like the Eagles? Will they be passing or playing?
We're playing.
Okay, we're playing. Okay. Hey. So the next person on there, Babette.
The Hawk. The Wind.
And the survey says...
Oh, come on, seriously?
As Minister Derry was talking, I was just thinking about how the environment has changed in terms of business and how people have to do business or now doing business. And so now when we think about business, we need to think about virtual ways.
Yeah, that's so true. And Cindy, I don't think Derry needed to introduce himself.
Yes, Derry has membership in every location.
Yeah, you know what? Since we got Derry on, which location do you actually belong to? Because when I go to Waukegan, he there. When I go to Bolingbrook, he there.
Yeah.
When I go to Chicago, he there. I went to Philadelphia, he was there. I mean, where Waukegan is your membership, bro?
I tell everybody, I'm the LIN ambassador.
Sounds like you're the Holy Spirit. Always will. Always will. No weapon formed against you shall be. Always will. It all sounds good. Always will. I always will. Always will. If God on my side, who can be against me? I'm all that a conqueror, yeah. I'm a winner, yeah.
Come on, somebody, open your mouth and give God the best praise that you have. Father, we lift you up, we exalt you, we glorify your holy name. We say that you are great and greatly to be praised. There's none like you. You're magnificent and holy. And we lift up our praise to you right now because we want heaven's attention. Yes, we want heaven's attention. Everybody in the room say,
we want heaven's attention.
Yes. Let's press in. So we release the sound with the clapping of our hands. Yes, we release the sound with the clapping of our hands. Come on, somebody declare it. Say, we release the sound, say.
We release the sound with the clapping of our hands.
Yes, we bless you, oh God. Yes, we release the sound.
I need you to post a status, tag me in it. It will be better. It's going to be better. I know it can't be compared, but it's going to be better. It's going to be better. It's going to be better. How do you lead a people who are broken? Oh God, oh God. And that's what a lot of us are going through. That's what a lot of the network pastors are experiencing. That's what a lot of pastors that are leading in today's society. You're trying to lead a broken people into a bountiful future. And it's hard. It's hard trying to lead people who've been hurt. It's hard trying to lead people who've been confused. It's hard trying to lead people who've gone through the ringer. It's hard trying to lead people who've been messed up in the mind. And you, like I, have had moments in your life where you've had to trust again after being hurt. These same people that were being delivered out of Babylonian captivity, that were being delivered out of slavery, had a mind issue. Because now, not only am I out of slavery, but I gotta build in a wilderness. I gotta build in ruin. I gotta go back to the last memory of my people and still build. And can I tell you that God is not only going to give you the strength to build, can I prophesy to you tonight that God's going to give you the power to overcome the pain of the past.